Today, we're exploring the 10 major hazards of working in confined spaces, making them some of the most challenging work environments. Confined spaces are areas with limited entry and exit routes, designed for periodic, not continuous, occupancy. This includes the likes of utility vaults, pits, manholes, tunnels, equipment housings, pipelines, silos, and sewers. Now, let's move on to the hazards associated with confined spaces. First, atmospheric hazards. These include toxic gases, vapors, or insufficient oxygen levels. Atmospheric hazards arise from both the nature of the stored materials and the external environment. Next, electrical hazards. These occur due to exposed wires, conductive materials, or operational electrical equipment within the confined space. Electrocution or electrical burns are significant risks, particularly in wet conditions or where protective measures are not in place. Workers in confined spaces may also be exposed to hazardous chemicals, such as hydrogen sulfide and carbon monoxide. Chemical burns, poisoning, and long-term health effects can occur depending on the toxicity and exposure level. Confined spaces often have limited access, which can impede both entry and exit in emergencies. This can result in delayed emergency response and difficulty in rescuing or evacuating workers quickly. High levels of oxygen in a confined space can be as dangerous as low levels, particularly due to the increased risk of fire and explosion. Elevated oxygen levels can cause materials that are normally non-flammable to ignite easily and burn intensely. Risks of fire in confined spaces may occur due to limited ventilation. Fires in confined spaces are particularly dangerous due to rapid spread and intense heat, compounded by difficulties in escape and firefighting. Flooding can also happen in confined spaces from internal sources like pipe bursts or external sources like heavy rainfall. This may result in drowning, hypothermia, and exposure to waterborne contaminants. Confined spaces can accumulate flammable gases, vapors, or dust, which can lead to explosions if ignited. Explosions can cause severe injury or death and significant structural damage. Extreme temperatures, either high or low, are a common hazard in confined spaces. Heat can lead to heat stroke and dehydration, while cold conditions can cause hypothermia and frostbite. Accumulation of combustible dust in confined spaces is a significant hazard. Combustible dust can lead to respiratory issues or, more critically, dust explosions. There you have it. Understanding these confined space hazards is your first step to working safely in these dangerous environments. Like what you learned? Hit the like button, subscribe, and click the bell icon to get more safety tips and updates.